Frosty, and welcome to Wednesday.
Guess what day it is?
I'm Quinn.
And I'm Jack.
First, we want to congratulate our In the Know team, who competed last night at Coastside against Dublin Drummond. The team consists of Danny Cordray, Matt Cross, Rosa Mama, and Hartha Med. Unfortunately, the team did not win, but they had great support. They want to thank Miss Nisi, Miss O, Mr. Ray, Mr. Christman, and Mr. Pratty for coming to the competition. The game will air in January.
Next up, remember we are still campaigning for animals, but this week the focus is on ASPCA, which is the prevention of cruelty to animals.
Today during your lunch, donate whatever you can. This is a great cause. If you donate a dollar, you will get a small prize as a thank you from us.
The weather continues to be great.
I know, right? Let's find out what's happening today.
Good morning, Central Crossing. I'm Sam.
And I'm Kit Kat.
What's for lunch today, Kit Kat?
We're having Big Daddy's Primo Pizza, meatball or rib sandwich, burrito, refried beans, and of course, salads and veggies.
Sounds great. What about the weather?
It's going to be a high of 68 degrees with a low of 46 degrees, 50% humidity, and winds at 13 miles per hour, along with rain.
Sounds cold and wet today, Kit Kat.
That's it from us. Back to you, Akers.
Thanks. Now let's check in on club news.
After school today, we have two groups get together. The first is CBS, Comet Bible Study, and Room 287. And then also meeting today is Key Club. They meet in the foods room at 3:30.
SAD, Students Against Destructive Decisions, meets early in the morning tomorrow. They get together at 7:20 in Room 259.
And then during the day on Thursday, there is a student council meeting during 7th period. Student council members should check in with their 7th period teacher and then head to the meeting.
Meeting Thursday after school is handmade by me. They meet in the foods room at 3:30.
Also meeting Thursday after school is Guitar Club. They meet together in Room 180.
Now let's see what's happening in sports.
Good morning, Comet athletes and fans. I'm Ethan. We have just a few things today. First, anyone interested in playing baseball this year must stop by the school store and get a calendar that has all information needed until the end of the school year. This will give you all information about lifting, conditioning, and games. Also, baseball lifting has begun. It runs Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays from 3:30 to 4:30. If you have any questions, see Coach Todd in the school store. Our first winter game is Friday. Our Comet ladies will take on Bishop Reedy at Reedy. It's a red out, so get a red shirt and plan out a short road trip to see our Lady Comet basketball players in their first game. That's it for today. Have a good one, Comets. Back to you.
Thanks, Ethan. Now let's check in with Mackenzie on current events.
Hello, Central Crossing. These past 2 days, we have talked about the attacks in Paris, which have been truly devastating. But I would like to talk about other attacks that have been similar to Paris and have occurred around the same time. In Beirut, Lebanon, 43 citizens lost their lives while 239 were wounded in a double suicide attack that occurred last Thursday, the day before the Paris attacks. Adele Termes was killed during the suicide bombing, but is being hailed as a hero in his town and across social media. He witnessed the first suicide bomb take place, and when he saw another suicide bomber running towards people, he ran and tackled him. The suicide bomber detonated the bombs, killing himself and Adele, but Adele sacrificed himself for other people around him. Another attack that has been getting viral attention is that one that occurred in the Kenyon University, which killed 147 people. This event occurred in April 2015, but did not get as much media coverage. But because of the Paris attacks, this event has resurfaced. That's it for today, anchors. Back to you.
Thanks, Mackenzie.
Next up, here's an easy way to do something. ROCKS is one of 8 national organizations that is in the running to receive $75,000. Lexi has some information for us.
Good morning, Central Crossing. We have had our ROCKS group girls for 3 years. ROCKS is a club for girls, and their statement is, "Ruling our experiences." The mission of ROCKS is to equip girls with the knowledge and skills necessary to live healthy, independent, productive, and violence-free lives. To create generations of confident girls who can control their experiences, relationships, and decisions. And to focus on safety, education, and the empowerment of girls. Central Crossing's very own group of ROCKS girls would like the community to vote for them. Go to shoeloverscare.com and click on the current votes. Scroll down and then vote for ROCKS. By voting, Central Crossing students can help ROCKS win $75,000. Keep voting until November 24th.
Thanks, Lexi. You can vote at shoeloverscare.com. Please vote today.
Next up, tomorrow and Friday and Monday and Tuesday next week, Renaissance Club will be kicking off our holiday warm-up sale by selling hot spiced apple cider in the cafeteria from 6:45 to 7:45. Pick up a cup of warm spiced cider for only 75 cents. Plus, for all you CCHS rewards card holders, gold card holders receive one free hot beverage. Silver and blue holders will receive one hot beverage at a discounted price. You will only have to show us your current card to receive your reward.
See you tomorrow, Friday or Monday, and Tuesday in the cafeteria.
That is it for today.
Have a great Wednesday.
See you tomorrow, Central.